Hola, SAP developers. I'm here to share with you some quick announcements on what's new for SAP BTP. The Launchpad service, Cloud Portal service, and SAP Workzone now support the Horizon theme. Administrators can select the new Horizon theme from their theme manager and enable it for end user selection for existing sites. There's a new version of SAP UI 5, 1.104. There are improvements to the spreadsheet export, integration cards, and changes in new features available for SAP Fiori elements. The details are included in the release notes. Cloud management tools. Two new operations have been added to the account service API of the SAP Cloud Management Service. The operations will allow you to easily delete BTP sub-accounts with data. This functionality is also available via the BTP command line interface. Now, be cautious when using this new feature, as sub-account data is deleted permanently. There's more updates available, and I encourage you to visit the What's New for SAP BTP website. Bookmark it and visit it frequently if you want to know the latest updates in the different BTP services.
We've got some great news for all you builders out there. If you're a user of the low-code tools extension in SAP Business Application Studio, you'll be pleased to know that the data center availability for this extension has been extended, and there's now also a free tier plan. In addition, there's a dedicated SAP Business Technology Platform booster. Get started with SAP Business Application Studio. There are also some new product enhancements in SAP Process Automation. There are enhanced conditions in the Process Builder. You can now add email notifications to processes via your SMTP server, which you can configure. You can now import and export decision content from and to Microsoft Excel. There's now a file upload widget, which you can add to the forms that you build. And there are also enhancements in the area of process visibility and automations. Check out all this latest and greatest news in Ludo's and Peter's blog posts.
Hi. Recently, Tobias Nietz started a blog post series called What's New in SAP AI Core and SAP AI Launchpad. In his Q2 blog from last week, he announced that AI Core now supports SAP HANA Cloud Data Lake files as object store. The Data Lake files are based on the Web HDFS protocol and give you the option to now store your artifacts directly within your SAP environment. AI Core now also allows metrics tracking of your machine learning models via the SAP AI Core SDK. This way you can use the SDK to log, query, modify and delete your metrics. And in addition to that, you can use AI Launchpad to compare and visualize metrics of your training jobs, either with tables or with different chart types available. You can now also use AI Launchpad to manage the Git repository connected to your AI Core instance, the sync applications, and the Docker registry secrets. You can also use AI Launchpad to perform the setup steps of AI Core. Furthermore, AI Launchpad now supports service key uploads to connect to your AI Core instance even faster. It supports new languages and is now available in 8 different languages. And with the new Meta API, you will now only see the capabilities of the AI API that are actually supported by your runtime.
July's SAP BTP Innobytes is out, edition 07 2022, with the latest highlights from the SAP Business Technology Platform, including innovations for application development and also for data and analytics. The Innobytes format is a conveniently short format, super consumable. Check out this month's episode and all the details on how to subscribe in Cecily's blog post.